was part of the journey. I was tripping around, you see. And then I found some gold in the ground. I got the fever inside me. The first thing I found was a mine with no name. It felt good to be high on the green. 'Cause in the mine, you can't remember your name. So awesome sauce became the claim. No, no.
Okay, so we're sitting here at a creek in North Carolina looking for a little bit of shiny. That's Heidi over there. I've got wife here, and then Derek's here too. So hopefully we find some cool stuff. I'll let you guys know soon, I hope. All right, have fun, rock on. Welcome back, everybody. So where we are is we're out in Osceola. We're in one of the old miners' cabins. This one has a false floor in it. It's kind of cool, but figured we'd check it out before we head back out. We found a pond with water fed by a spring, but not enough water for us to do anything with because it's stagnant. It's stanky. So look at that view. Couple old mines up over there, you can see. Show you what this building looks like. There's Matt. It's a double roomed building. You got this first one, which seems like they probably slept some stuff in this one, and then the back one was like cooking or whatever. So
they had running water at one point.
Yeah, they definitely had running water here. There's springs everywhere. Where'd Dusty go? So we're gonna head back to the truck and head back to camp in town. Dig us a pond for water retention and fill it up, and hopefully we can get something done over there today. So, rock on, everyone. We got a little hike back. Talk to you later.
Come on, Dusty.
All right, everybody, welcome back. So, we've made it back to the cabin and the camp space where we're camping on the private property. There's our tents. We've got a shitter over there, which makes things easy. This is what we're going to use for our running pond. Hopefully, it holds out long enough for us to get something. So, but it's just 3.5 millimeter black plastic. We could have made our recovery sections bigger, but oh well, we'll be good. So, we'll let you guys know what we find. It's Dusty. Yep, beer 30. So we're sitting at camp now, because we're done with stuff today. That's the cooker right there that we use. That's the table, and that's our fire heat pit that we just finally got cleaned out. We've got our double setup of tents there. We've got the Bill Marriott house right here. And then we've got Grub Gulch out that way, and then Jake's Gulch this way, and Jack's Gulch. And we got a few other cool areas out that way. But it's time for drinking. So, talk to you later. Have fun. Rock on, everyone. Alright, so me and Matt are out looking for our cell service. We had earlier today and we came to what we thought was a cell site, but we are getting no cellular reception like we were earlier. And I don't think it's normal that they have a rotating camera on them. I don't know if you guys can see the camera moving. Let me stop moving here in a second so you can really see it. Check that out. And it's not moving because of the wind. This thing's moving independently. I don't know what's up with that. It goes completely opposite directions of the wind. Like right here, look at that. The wind's not going that way. Wind is going this way. On my back. It's creepy. It says Sacramento Pass. Kind of looks like it's an air duct. But I don't know. So here we are. Sacramento Pass, Intermountain Power Agency, Telecommunications Facility, BLM file, blah, 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 emergency contact, explosives, gas. Nice good lock on it. There's the tower. Yeah, it looks like radio to me, but
it's gotta be radio.
It says telecommunications right here. So telecommunications leads me to think it would have been a, it would be. But it's creepy, that's for sure. We're gonna head off to the area where we got reception earlier and see if it comes back or what's going on, if this is the cell site or if there's another cell site that we were picking up or something. So, it's coming towards us. Looks like an air vent. That's just creepy how it's making its own pattern on where it's going. I don't understand that. Here it comes again. Against the wind. Yeah, the wind is on my back. It shouldn't be facing me ever. That's just freaking weird. Sounds like a fan for sure. About 8:30, I think. Pretty dark out here. Kind of creepy. Well, I think y'all have seen enough on this for now. We'll be back later to show you. I don't know, maybe we'll get some cellular reception or something, but we're out of here for now. See you tomorrow morning or something. Rock on. Alright, everybody, so we made it to the spot just up the road that has the cellular receptions. Still see the same tower down there, but don't see the cellular tower. So we're not sure what's going on with that. Or at least I'm not sure what's going on with that one. But I'm going to take care of some calls and some other business and whatever else I need to do on the phone real quick. And I don't know. Probably see you tomorrow. But rock on. Have fun.
Phenomenal.
I wish the little barrel would flare up again. All right, everybody, welcome back. It's about, I don't know, midnight-ish. Me and Matt are out here doing a little late-night panning and celebrating with the little, if I can get it go, bad lighter, come on. Celebrating with a little tiny firework. Whee! That was so much fun. Now what me and Matt have here right now is we've got these two half buckets of material here. We both took about a half a pan each in our pan and panned them. Both got a couple little pieces of gold. Let's see if I can actually show you in here. Might be able to. Yeah, I'm not going to be able to show you anything in this light. I'd have to go and stop this and put the light on, so I'll do that. Okay, so we're back here. Let me clean this down just a little bit. And mind you, this is just two of these small pans that we ran to get this amount that I'm about to show you. Anybody see them there yet? No, probably not. He is not too good on that. But it's clearing out well enough for you to see here in a second. So alright, so there you guys go. There's the two pieces, three pieces, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10 pieces of gold from two small little what do you call these? Cleanup pans, I guess you could say. So just to show you some gold at least, you know. So I'm gonna get off of here and I'm gonna drink some moonshine and pan some gold maybe. Okay, have fun everyone. Rock on. Okay, welcome back everybody. It's another day. We're just doing some panning of some material that we found out here. Figured we'd go through it before we go do much else. But it's almost lunchtime. We're gonna widen this hole a bit larger so we have more containment for our material when we run. Other than that, we're pretty much ready to go after we set up our sluice and high banker, which we have a problem with that. The rats at the other site decided they were gonna chew through the hoses, a bunch of holes. So, yay. Gonna have to figure that fun one out too. At least the ants aren't freaking out today. Well, rock on everyone. Talk to you soon. Welcome back, guys and girls. We're looking at some of the buildings here in Osceola right now. Osceola is in Nevada, about kind of central on the border of Utah. We're known for gold nuggets coming around 22 pounds, somewhere around there is the largest known out here. What we're doing, as you know, is running a little bit of material, doing some work out here and playing around. We got the guys over here using the recirculating pond and everything. There, hopefully we'll have something cool to show everybody on this little run here. Here's a cool old piece of equipment. Anybody know what that one is? So here's the recovery pond that we're using right now. Just some 3.5 millimeter plastic. I think I said that already. But This material's got a lot of clay in it, so we're running the high banker right now so we can make sure we break up our clay clots as much as we can. So, just running a little 2-inch water pump from Harbor Freight. Here's where we're camping. Now this area is also known for some of the best hunting in all of Nevada. And some of the best fishing in all of Nevada is only about 50 miles away, a little farther north. But so much to do out here on vacation or whatever you want to do. If you want to get a hold of us and come out and play. We're trying to get something going with a couple of companies to get people out here and start having maybe a hotel and some other cabins, whatever, something going on out here. So, wishing it all luck. This is to Bill Marriott. Thank you. Okay, everybody, so what's going on right now is Matt's panning the last of the cons from the run that we just did, which was 8 buckets. None of them were completely full either, so. Those heavies are just sitting. See the gold right there.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see if we can pick those out by hand. The big piece of the rock. They're just in the way.
Oh, really heavy stuff.
I like really heavy stuff though. Alright everybody, there's the little bit of gold that we got today. I just want to show you and we'll talk to y'all later. Okay everybody, I don't know if you can see the gold that's right here. Pull it out so you can. Look at that. It's like 4 or 5 pieces over there. It's nice. Some's right here. There's a bit in the ribbed matting. I expect to find a good amount in here today. But we're gonna do a cleanup real quick and we'll show you what we found. Rock on everyone. All right everybody, so after that run of a couple buckets that we ran, we got this much here, which is about almost a gram, somewhere right around there. We're pretty happy. We'll be hopefully getting into some more of that material and getting some good gold, so. Rock on everyone, we're running this to see what we find out of here. Hoping we find something more coarse than we found there, because this came from farther up in the gulch. So wish us luck and rock on. See you soon.
So heavy it won't even stay out there.
Right? So welcome back everybody. What we got for, what do you think we ran? Maybe half a yard, maybe about a ton. We got about, looks like about 2 grams to me. So, we'll see what we can get the next day and a half before we have to leave for our meeting. And we'll show you after that. But for now, we got stuff to do, so rock on and have fun. All right, everybody, well, we're just out exploring before we go grab some material real quick. Just wanted to see what we can see over here. Well, we're gonna head on. Have fun. See you soon. I just wanted to show you guys what we're digging. I don't know if I did at the last spot, but the last spot we were digging was in a wall like that with the big boulder under it. And then we've got this pile that one of our friends is nice enough to take out of where he's digging and pile some up for us so that we have easier digging, which is nice of him. Makes it easier for us. But let me go show you what that hole looks like. There you go. We're into a lot of good sized boulders there too, so we could be getting better gold now. There used to be a creek that came right down there. This is bedrock here and then the main wash here, so this should be a really good spot for collecting. So I'm gonna get back down there, help him out. But we're gonna take as much of this pile as we possibly can. So I'll show you what we get. Rock on. Hey, welcome back everybody. So we're at Mount Wilson Ranch right now. This is what their rooms are looking, well, one of their rooms look like. They all kind of have their own little different look. Kind of late right now, kind of got in late. But we're here on an invite to come check out the property and see if we want to help them out. And this place is really cool. I think everybody would like it. It's cute, rustic, quaint. We'll show you more in the morning. But I'm gonna go to bed. It's late. So rock on, everyone. Have fun. Okay, so I guess I didn't go to bed. I just want to show you guys what it looks like at night, just right here out of the room. So that over there is like, I guess you could call it the lounge on this side right over here. Here would be, I guess you could call it, you know, kitchen-ish type area, half lounge. And then this side over here that you can't see because it's in the dark, but that would be what they call the bar. Bi-level with loft and patio on two floors. It's really cool. It's freaking awesome. I'll show you what it looks like tomorrow when I do a little tour. But just wanted to show off what it looks like at night because it's so pretty. I don't know if camera's doing it any justice because you kind of have to be here yourself to see this and experience it. It's great. They have plenty of rooms for anybody who wants to stay. Look how dark it is over there. Look, you can see stars. Oh wait, not through the camera. Damn. I was enjoying the view of the Milky Way earlier though. That was great. But anyhow, rock on and have fun again. Good night. Yeah, I'm back again. You're right. Okay, so supposedly this room is the haunted room, which is room number 3. In the upper area. If you like haunted stuff, I'm pretty sure there might be something here. You might want to check it out. I get responses on almost every question. So, try it. I don't know. Who knows? Not a bad room though. I like it. Look, a dream catcher also in every room. That's just too cool. Rock on.
All right. So everybody, where we're at right now is we're at the Mount Wilson Ranch. This is the common hangout area. They've got the fire pit. They've got a spa for you to hang out in after a long day's work. If we go this way, we can see where the hotel rooms are, which are quite quaint. They're rustic. Nice little hot tub. They've got their little restaurant here, the kitchen, another, and then down over here there's a bar, which we'll show you that here in a minute. Figure we'll give you a look-see at where the hotel is first. right over here, they have three rooms for people to stay in, two beds in each. They all come with a refrigerator. Over here, we'll go in here and we'll check this out.
Up to you, Matt. We'll go this way.
What they have over here is just kind of like a little museum going on, showing you some of the old cool stuff they have. I think they do sell a few products like old pans and stuff like that for people to use if they need one, but right over here would be the eating area, common eating, where people get to spend their mornings or their evening. We've got a patio up back for if you want to eat and spend time outside. Great view out there too.
They actually have a couple of ponds. They're empty now because the season's been so dry, but they have a small lower pond and then an upper pond out this way that's much larger. So I got three barbecues out here. Nobody says, hey, I can't cook. Let's go show the kitchen real quick. Next room we're going in here is to the kitchen. It's a little dark. Find the light switch. No light switch, but somewhere. There it is. Maybe that wasn't it. Well, anyhow, if you can see what's going on in here, it looks like a kitchen, right? They are able to feed around 200 people with this kitchen if needed. So if you're looking for a large group event, you can do it here. And then down over here, they have another sitting room with TV and stuff. Got a nice little fireplace. Here's a cool bottle. It's I can't remember the Lucky Buddha name is what it's called. That beer is actually really good. We've got a nice hearth fireplace here. Nice couches to hang out with. I got some books if you read books. When we come into here, we got the men's shower and the women's shower that are for people who are camping, because they do have campsites here for everybody. This in here is their bar. It runs off of donation. So you feel like hanging out in the bar, leave a tip. We've got another TV in here for watching movies. We've got a loft up top. We'll go look at that here in a minute. Gotta love a pool table, right? And this bar actually came from, I think he said, Trinity area of California. Had it dismantled and brought down here. Got a player piano. Check out the cougar skin here, guys. That is actually a local animal. That's how big they get. The bear isn't, just the cougar. There's a five-part stud there, right? Then we're gonna come upstairs to the loft and the bar. Check that out. Check out the patio real quick. Give you guys a view of what it looks like there.
here's the patio. I'm told you can get cellular reception from the far left corner. There you go, Jeff coming.
Great view from every direction out here.
Great for quadding. Great rides.
I forgot about. Horseback riding, quadding, hunting, gold mining. You name it that you want to do out here. If you're an outdoors person, this is the place you want to probably hang out if you can.
Mount Wilson Ranch.
Very comfortable and very quaint. Definitely worth hanging out here. Express wanted. Young, skinny, wiry fellows, not over 18. Must be expert riders willing to risk death daily. Orphans preferred. Wages $25 per week. Apply at the Pony Express Stables, St. Joseph, Missouri. I don't think I would ever have done that job. Somebody was always trying to double the steel they had. Yeah, we can go up this way. The rest of the little, what did I say it was, museum that they have out here. Still working, nice. With the baby sled, that's cool. And then we're gonna come across the hangout room again, and that is interesting. Wonder what that is. I think it's a fossilized poop. Here's something cool for you guys to look at. This is what they would stick into the beams inside the mine shafts. They'd either stab it in or they'd hang it. And that's the light that they used when they're in there. If you're ever in a mine shaft, take out your Bic lighter if you have one and light it and imagine that's the light that they were working on. Then there's like a snake skin. What's the Veteran Gold? Cool book. A lot of cool books here. Now we're gonna go down around the other side and show you where the other group stay rooms are. Alright, well, this area here, this is the group stay cabin area. All of these are connected to each other, so if you have, say, 12 people in your party or more, you can all have an adjoining room and just have one big party. Which this one I think is actually right on the other side of the pond that they have, which is dry right now. They do have a chicken coop down over here on the other side. They have horses and goats over here on the right hand side. Thank you. one connects over to the other one from here. I don't think it connects to the one in the front, though. I think that one's more of a private room. Oh, this one's really cute. Look at this one, Matt. These rooms here are non-smoking, but you can smoke on property outside as long as you put your butts in a can. So. One's got a cute wrapping to it. I like how all of them are slightly different. And I think every single room has a dream catcher hanging in it also. I think I noticed that. And then you've got the one here with the kitchenette in it. Which this one here would be my favorite because it's got the full kitchen and two rooms. Can't beat a mini suite, can you? This is nice looking also. That's you, huh? That's a cool building, isn't it? Fireplace. Over here they have one of the old homesteads that's been here since the 1800s. Made out of hand-hewn trees that were out here. They packed all the tracks with mud, which was the average way to insulate back then. Make it so that people can actually stay in it, but I don't know. So this is the door. Oh, this is cool. Yeah, this is stable. I'd stay in this. Yeah, bouncy floor, right? This is a cool piece of train track from the mining shaft. Nice little homestead. Needs a little work to make it usable. Chicken. I wish I knew the names and types of chickens. Look at that dog, he's big. Just got a big talk.
Fresh eggs all year.
Yeah, that's all I see. cool old dump truck that used to be property of the city, or well, county of Lincoln, which we're in Lincoln County right now. Lincoln County actually has somewhere around 50,000 old registered mines in it. So, and then White Pine County is another 20 miles up, I think. Which, in White Pine County, that's where Osceola is. Down over here, we've got the, I'm pretty sure this is where the horse stable is. And I'm pretty sure because it looks like a horse stable.
That's a pony.
So here's where the horse corral is. That's a little pony.
Or mini horse, one of them.
Place for the whole family.
Yeah. Too bad my kids decided that they wanted to do something else instead of coming out here and meeting everybody. They would have liked it. Come here, come here. Come here. No, okay.
That's the group bunk, the chicken coop. The old homestead right there. Just wanted to show it because it has a cool view. But ooh, that's another good view. Well, we're getting ready to head back to Vegas. So we'll talk to you all soon. If you want to come for a visit out here, get a hold of me. We'll try and set you up. And you can maybe spend a week or something out here at the Mount Wilson Ranch. Maybe with your horses or your quads or whatever the hell you want. You can hunt. Not too much fishing right now because of the season. But see if I can find any of the old equipment that was sitting out over here. A lot of cool old farming and mining artifacts out here for those of you who like to admire them. So here's the bar and saloon again. And there's the rooms we're staying in. Well, we're staying in. So rock on, everyone, and we'll talk to you soon. Have fun. All right, everybody, welcome back again. We're on the trip back home. I'm not gonna tell anybody where we are because I don't like to. So we'll call it Secret River. But we're gonna come back out with the dredge permit and get to work out here. We did a little bit of panning and found good numbers and a handful of dirt. So where I'm thinking would be a great area to high bank out of is get material out of all there. Throw that in with it, and then all this whole area over here would be great for it. So, all this big rock. And the floods hit up to the roots area of that tree too, so. You can see the debris on that tree right there. Shows you how high up the water comes when the floods come through. So, anyhow, we're gonna go. Have fun. Rock on, everyone. See you soon.